Going into your first year of Doberman ownership with a brand new puppy can be really rough. Yes, even for me, I promise you. And honestly, sometimes you just feel like a fighter entering the ring for the very first time with no idea what to expect. And just like a brand new fighter, sometimes it can hurt when reality finally hits. Down. Down.
Please leave me alone for 5 minutes. 5 minutes. Just make it stop. Please just somebody make it stop.
Yeah, it can be a really rude awakening, but you know what? By the end of this video, you're gonna know the three arguably worst stages of Doberman ownership with a brand new puppy, and you'll know one really cool method that you can use that just instinctually clicks with Dobermans and will help you make it through some of these really hard times. So guys, this video isn't a list of every struggle you're gonna face with your Doberman puppy in that first year, but it's a list of the three most intense phases that you're gonna face. Okay, so the first phase is those first few weeks at home. And honestly, things can start as soon as you walk in through the door with your new pup. You know, it's all fun and games. You got your new pup, you're real excited, but right about the time your puppy has their first accident in the house, that's gonna be your cue that things might be a little amiss and there might be some challenges ahead. And that first night with your pup, with a Doberman pup, can be really tough. You know, usually most people get their puppy between 8 to 12 weeks old. They're used to sleeping with their litter mates, and they're definitely big Velcro dogs. They love being around people. And if you're crate training them, you can definitely be in for some crying the first night and a real severe lack of sleep. You may have to take them out as often as every 2 to 4 hours during even their first few weeks with you. So don't expect to get a whole lot of sleep those first few weeks. Be prepared for that. And honestly, you need to know the difference between a whine for attention, which is really common, and a whine because they have to go to the bathroom. And I actually did a video all about surviving the first night with your Doberman pup, which talks about how to tell a difference between a cry for attention and a cry because they have to go to the bathroom. That's really important to know. Take a look up in the corner of your screen. It should be popping up right now. So really those first few weeks will consist of a severe lack of sleep, cleaning up the occasional mess in the house, following your dog around, watching their every move, making sure they're not chewing on something they shouldn't chew on, making sure they're not getting into something that they could choke on, all at the same time, trying to make sure they stay integrated with the family, because you can't just put them in a kennel or something like that during that stage. It's very important that they're a part of the family during all of that. So that's just a combination for a really tough time. Next up is a juvenile delinquent phase, which usually is around 12 to 16 weeks of age. And this is a phase where they're really testing their position in the pack. They're gonna test the alpha in the house. And kind of there's a lot of dominance comes into play there. And Dobermans are naturally fairly dominant dogs. So that's why this stage can be particularly tough with this specific breed. And this is where the biting and the nipping that Doberman owners complain about so much come into play, especially with their young puppies. It's usually during this stage. And this nipping and biting is usually just done during playtime, but it can also be kind of a jockeying for position with the alpha leader type of thing. So that's why it's really important not to allow mouthing during this stage, and also to avoid any kind of very rough and extreme kind of tug of war games and that kind of thing. Have a plan on how to handle that nipping and the biting before you get to this stage. And if you need help with that, I have a video on that too. It should also be popping up in the corner of your screen. This is also the phase where your dog's stubbornness will come out, and Dobermans are known for being a little headstrong, so it's really common. And a lot of Doberman owners will describe this stage as something they feel like they just have to put their head down with and just kind of hold their breath and make it through. And really, it can be like that sometimes. The most important thing during this stage is to have a plan for your training and stick to that plan with rock solid consistency. And as long as you've stuck to that plan, you will make it to the maturity stage. Trust me, this is just temporary. I know it feels like it's not, but it is temporary. And when you hit that maturity level, if you stayed rock solid consistent with the training all the way through the previous stages, everything's gonna be fine. So the next big stage you're gonna go through is that teething stage, which is usually between about 16 weeks of age to 6 months of age. And that's the time when they're feeling everything with their mouth, they're chewing on things they shouldn't be, including you. Don't let that happen. They're going in the backyard and pulling out plants. You know, and a lot of that can be anxiety related. But if it's in that 16 week to 6 month time frame, usually more often than not, it has to do with the teething, and they just have sore gums and sore teeth at that point, and they're trying to feel all different things to alleviate that. The best thing you can do during that stage is to provide as many toys, and I'm just talking just a slew of toys and options of good things they're allowed to chew on that are all different textures, types, and feelings on their gum. You can throw in some frozen toys and frozen treats. That'll provide just one more means for them to alleviate that feeling in their mouth, and that'll make a big difference. Also, just make sure you keep your dog well exercised, because an exercised dog is a happy dog, and they're not gonna be near as bothered by that sore feeling in their mouth. So the best thing I found to get you through any of these, like even the most difficult stages with your Doberman puppy, is to lock them into a really good, solid daily routine. And honestly, I think this is how you be successful in a lot of areas in your life, is to get in a good routine, a daily routine that fosters the end goal that you want. And if something about a daily routine with Dobermans, it just clicks for them. It's natural, it's instinctual. It really actually even relieves a lot of their anxiety. They love knowing what's coming. Think of a guard dog that just loves their same patrol route every day. And that's what a Doberman is a guard dog. They love that consistent routine. So use that to your advantage. Lock in a routine that's gonna foster them getting through these phases with the least amount of pain on you as possible. And you're gonna have the Doberman gods working in your favor. So here are a few important aspects of a good, well-rounded daily routine for your Doberman. The first one is a good morning routine. Wake up with your dog, head out to the backyard, make your dog go through their doggy door if you have one, not through the human door, and go relieve themselves. Do this every day so that your dog learns the first thing they do when they wake up is not to sniff around the house and get distracted until they have an accident, but the first thing to do is to wake up and go through their dog door, head out to the backyard and relieve themselves. And then after that, have a consistent time and place where you feed your dog breakfast, because it's natural for dogs to have anxiety surrounding when they're gonna get their next meal. And if you keep that really rock solid consistent, you can take away a lot of their daily anxiety just with that. The next thing is to have a routine with how they're gonna get their exercise every day that you can stick with. Dobermans need 1 to 2 hours of exercise on average every day. So how's that gonna look? Are we gonna do maybe a half hour of exercise in the morning, a half hour in the evening with a bunch of playtime in between? You can totally break it up like that, that's fine. They just need about 1 to 2 hours every single day. Also have a good routine built around training every day. You should be training your dog every single day, even if it's only 15 minutes when you get a chance, but try to keep it the same time every day, because teaching your dog, even just working with some single one word commands, for example, with your dog, helps establish you as a pack leader and helps keep them focused on you as their owner, which will pay off a lot down the road when you're trying to teach them other behaviors. Also have a routine built around playtime, because playtime is a great bonding experience with your dog. If they know a playtime's coming, they'll be potentially a lot more relaxed throughout the day. And it'll also help them kick that protectiveness that sometimes Dobermans have around like their favorite toy, for example. And it'll teach them gentle play as well. You should also have exposure to new things worked into your daily routine, especially in that about 8 to 16 week old window. During that time frame, that's the age where it's considered the critical socialization period for Doberman specifically. So that period is so important to expose them to as many new people, as many new animals, dogs, sights, sounds, textures, new things as you possibly can. So work that in your daily routine. Have a little chunk of time set aside where you just show your dog something new, even if it's something as simple as going in the backyard and making some new crazy noise with the gardening tools that you don't normally make. Something little like that every single day will go a long way by the time they hit that maturity level of 1 to 2 years of age. And just remember, guys, make a routine that you can stick to that fosters the end result you want of a really well-rounded adult Doberman. And by the time they hit adult 1 to 2 years of age, they're gonna be doing really, really well. And I know we hate getting out of our own routines, but now you got a Doberman puppy, it's gonna happen. Just remember, be consistent, hang in there, and a lot of those bad behaviors from Dobermans just dissolve away when they hit maturity, especially when they've had an owner that's established a really good daily routine that fosters a well-rounded adult dog. If you want help with a lot of these stages and a lot of the other difficult parts of raising a Doberman dog designed specifically for Doberman owners, check out a lot of the other videos on my channel. I've done videos on all the hardest parts. That way you don't get in over your head, much like I was when I got my first Doberman. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button down below and the little bell icon that comes up next to it. And hey, before you go anywhere, why don't you check out that video on your screen right now, especially that top video. YouTube is saying that you're gonna like that top video the most out of all my videos. I don't know, is YouTube right? I'm not sure. Why don't you click it and find out.